All right, second type, a convergent boundary. A convergent boundary is where they converge or move toward one another. Here, when one plate meets another plate, you'll see that one of the plate gets forced down underneath. It's always going to be the denser plate. We know that oceanic crust has a density of 3.0. Continental has a density of 2.7. So when oceanic meets continental, 3.0 is denser, it will be forced underneath. But when the two meet and the one gets driven underneath, it will actually tug on the other one, pull it down, and create a V-shaped valley. This is a trench here. This is happening where the part of the convection current is starting to sink and go back deeper into the mantle. And if you can imagine, as this rock tends to go deeper, it will get hotter, which will cause it to melt. And when it melts, it will turn into the magma that can work its way up to the surface and either make an island, an underwater sea mountain that can continue to grow above sea level and maybe become an island. Or if it's land masses, we can get volcanoes showing up. We can get volcanic mountains formed. So you'll tend to get trenches and what's called volcanic island arcs, which are islands that parallel the trenches. And we see a good example of that right here in the second picture. We'll jump to the second picture. We have two oceanic plates coming together. One of them has to be a little bit denser than the other, and that's the one that will subduct underneath, make the trench. Right here is where the magma is cooling and hardening. Where the rock, rather, is melting. Said that backwards. And turning into magma, which will work its way up to the surface and create underwater volcanic mountains. And if they grow large enough, they will pop above the water and become islands. If we jump up to the first one, here's a nice example of continental crust meeting oceanic crust. We get our trench, and we get our mountains that parallel it also. You'll find this on the west coast of South America, also west coast United States. And finally, the last one, if we have two continental crusts coming together, they'll crash into each other. Not much subduction is going to happen. They'll be pushed upward because they're actually less dense than the asthenosphere in the mantle. So they're not going to go down. They're going to get pushed up and create mountains, most notably the Himalayan mountains and Mount Everest, which are the tallest ones in the world. And our last type is a transform plate boundary. And real simply, that's when the two plates slide past each other side by side. Here you can see the ocean, they're sliding side by side. Most famous example is the San Andreas Fault. You get a great picture of it from the right, looking right down the fault line. You can see one side on the right is on one plate, the side on the left is on another plate. Take a look at where it is. It's on the west coast of California, west coast of the United States, running right through California. And an interesting part is Los Angeles is actually on the Pacific plate side, moving to the north. San Francisco is on the North American plate side. So eventually, Los Angeles could be next door to San Francisco. Again, these plates here are moving side by side. And here, you can pause this, take a look at it. You have a nice picture of the three different types of plate boundaries, different scenarios of each. But one thing I do want to point out is this transform boundary, not only will you find it like we just showed the San Andreas Fault, but if you look right here, they'll show it right here. This is in the middle of the ocean. And what happens here is this mid-ocean ridge here continued over here. This was all the same ridge. But if you notice, it's offset because this side might have shifted to the right or to the east, causing them to be offset. So this is a fault line in here where one moves left, one moves right, and they're offset from each other. So you can also have a transform fault that way. And a lot of the mid-ocean ridges will be kind of jagged offset mountains just like this, showing transform faults. In this example, you see a mid-ocean ridge, which is a divergent boundary, offset by the transform fault up in the middle, where the white arrow is showing it moving to the side, separating the mid-ocean ridge. You can also see here a transform boundary showing how the San Andreas Fault has California, part of California, moving to the north. All right, finishing up, the Ring of Fire. It's that ring around the Pacific Ocean. It's where we have most of our earthquakes and volcanoes, and it basically shows us the edge of the Pacific Ocean. Take a look at it here. It's going right around the Pacific plate. Trenches are the blue lines, and volcanic and earthquake activities are the red lines. This picture here, if we were to plot a lot of earthquakes, this is what it would look like. And what you're going to see is there's a pattern of where they are. And they're all concentrated in pretty much the same regions, right around this Pacific ring here. Also, right through the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, we have a bunch. Right down the west coast of South America. And these are plate boundaries. If we take a look at this, we'll see that these regions, right around the Pacific plate, are where all those earthquakes were. Again, in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, on the west coast of South America. Now, this is the chart from our reference tables, and what this shows us is the plates, their names, also gives you latitude and longitude up top, so don't forget that that's there. And what it's really providing us information for is the names of the plate boundaries, or the types of the plate boundaries. The divergent boundary is the parallel lines, the arrows will show the relative motion of the plate, so here they're moving away from each other. And you can see that here. You can see it in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. So that's a divergent plate boundary. Convergent plate boundary will be shown with the solid dark line, thick line with rectangles on it. And you can see it in the Western Pacific. You can see it along the west coast of South America. And finally, that transform plate boundary where they go side by side. Remember I said in San Andreas Fault right here is a famous one. But you'll also see right here how these parallel lines are offset from each other. These divergent plate boundaries here are offset because of a transform plate boundary here that slid down left and right. The last thing on here is a mantle hotspot. And that's an area where magma is able to push its way through the crust, but it's not at a plate boundary. And you'll see that at Hawaii. So Hawaii, it's volcanic, but it's not on a plate boundary. In fact, it's right in the middle of the Pacific plate. It's kind of interesting. And also Yellowstone National Park. That's also a hot spot, not on a plate boundary. Both of these regions have a lot of volcanic activity. And you'll see volcanoes, obviously, on Hawaii. And we'll talk a little bit more about which way the Hawaiian Islands are moving from this hot spot, which helped to prove the direction that the plate's moving. And that's it for a quick introduction into plate boundaries. Remember to go back, pause, rewind it as you need, and get the information down best that you can.